I received a lot of requests to show you guys how to use the calculator to graph the unit circle. I posted something earlier, however, on the web, however, I didn't like how the video actually worked out, so I'll show you something a little bit different here. On your screen you see my TI-83. First thing we're going to do is I'll scroll down here and we're going to click mode and make sure that we are in radian mode. I'm just scrolling down here. I am in radian mode. Also make sure you're in parametric mode. We're going to actually make a pair of parametric equations, so I'll select that. Select y equals at this point. Now you see on your screen you have x equals nothing, y equals nothing. So we're dealing with trig functions. The x value is always associated with the cosine. The y value is always associated with the sine. Let's go ahead and do that. And a couple people might have a problem. If your plots are on, please turn them off. You don't need that. You'll have errors when you go to plot things. If I were to hit graph right now, I'd have an issue. Likely my window wouldn't turn out nicely, or I may have some issues with my t value, which I'll talk about in a moment. So we're going to have to go and click on window to adjust things. This t min that you see here refers to my angle. My minimum angle is 0. My maximum angle, I'm going to hop down here and enter 2 pi. Now, this actually was already set at 2 pi, but I'm just showing you how to do it. The t-step that you see right here is how our angle is going to be increasing on our graph. If we trace it out, how do we want each step to increase by, or what number do we want to increase by for each step? I think your homework asks you for pi over 12, so we're going to just insert here pi divided by 12. The reason for pi over 12 being a very special t-step is because multiples of pi over 12 give you your special angles. So for example, 2 pi over 12 is pi over 6, which is one of your special angles. 3 pi over 12 is pi over 4, which is another special angle. And 4 pi over 12 is pi over 3. Which is, again, a special angle. 5 pi over 12 is the redheaded stepchild. Okay, so your x min and x max, this is what we want our window range to look like. So what bounds the left and right hand sides of our screen. Since this is a unit circle, I'm just going to start with x min to be negative 1.5 and go to an x max of 1.5. I'll keep my x scale here at 1. It's just the tick marks on the x-axis, so every one they place a tick mark. The y-minimum I'm actually going to set to negative 1, and the y-maximum on the screen will be a positive 1. Again, my y-scale is at 1. The reason why I chose my y-minimum and maximums to be different than my x-minimums and maximums is because your screen on your calculator is like a widescreen TV. So you have to adjust. If I want to look at a perfect circle, I have to actually adjust my screen for that. If you don't understand that, that's not a big deal. So if I hit graph right now, see I get a pretty little unit circle. And the questions usually on a homework assignment are something like, okay, from this, tell me what the sine of pi over 3 is from the unit circle. Well, I would do that by hitting trace. You see I have my little cursor's right there. And then I can hit... I'll scroll down here so you can see. I hit this little right arrow button here. When I do that, let's scroll this back up. When I do that, I start moving around the circle. Notice these t values are increasing when I do that. So my angle is increasing. Look at this angle right now. It's at 3.14. That's actually pi, right? 3.1415927, blah, blah, blah. And this x value is the cosine of pi. This y value is the sine of pi. Notice, by the way, it's kind of a unique thing, that it says the sine of pi here is negative 4.1 e to the negative 10th. Whenever you see e to the negative 10th or something like that, that basically means zero. It's just your calculator can't figure it out. It's not smart enough, so it does that. All right, so if I wanted to know, for example, what the cosine of 2 pi over 3 was, I'd have to search around for some decimal version of 2 pi over 3. One thing you can do, which I wouldn't recommend, but you could do this, you could quit out of this and figure out what 2 pi over 3 is as a decimal. It's 2.09 blah. So I'll hit graph again, hit trace, and I'll try to find 2.09 blah. There's my angle, 2.09 blah right there. It tells me that the cosine, which is the x value, is a negative 0.5. That should make sense because the cosine is negative in quadrant 2, so that works out. And if you were to actually draw one of your special triangles, you could see that in quadrant 2, the angle 2 pi over 3 has a reference angle of pi over 3. You draw that little special triangle and you find out that the cosine is actually negative 1/2 or negative 0.5. Along the same lines, we see that the sine of 2 pi over 3 is 0.8660254. Now, I don't want to constantly drop down like this and have to calculate, let's say, 5 pi over 6 or 7 pi over 6 or these, you know, find some decimal expansion. But you don't have to. If you hit graph and then hit trace here, let's say I wanted to find out the sine of 4 pi over 3. All I have to do is type in 4 pi over 3. Make sure you had pressed trace prior to doing this. Once you hit enter, you see 4 pi over 3 is this number. The cosine is a negative 0.5. The sine is a negative 0.8660254. Now, you are armed with all the information you need to use the unit circle on the calculator. I will be very honest with you, it's not that useful otherwise, other than this homework. I find that using the right triangles and the quadrants to be much more advantageous. Before I leave, though, I do want to mention, this is only talking about, we're only talking about radians. If you had a homework problem that said, oh, do this with degrees, I'd go down to mode here, click mode, and I would change my calculator to degree mode. So I hop down, go over to degree mode, hit enter, and then I'd click on window. Well, first maybe I should hit y equals. I see I'm still cosine and sine for x and y. My window, my angles are going to go from 0 to 6 degrees. So I need to change that. 0 to 360 is what I really want. And the increment that I'm going to do for my angles will be, let's just say, 10 degrees. And everything else I'll leave the same. If I hit graph, again, the same beautiful circle. By the way, just something really tricky. Not tricky, but interesting, I suppose. If I would have said 345 here and hit graph, you see it graphs 0 all the way to 345. It doesn't go all the way to 360. So that's why that's an illustration of that T-max. Anyway, not that interesting, I suppose. And so now I can do the same stuff. Like, I hit trace. I see that if my angle is 10 degrees, my cosine is 0.98 blah. I go around. I can find the cosine of 70 degrees now by typing in 70. That would be 0.342, so on and so forth. I could do the cosine or the sine of 350 degrees if I wanted to. And that's negative 0.1736. Okay, I hope this helps you guys out. Have a great evening or day, whatever it may be when you're viewing this, and I'll see you in class.